Have you guys seen Casey Neistat's latest mega vlog yet? Well, it did this pretty cool transition from a scene
to his laptop. Hey,
something like this. Pretty cool, huh? It's very simple
to create. And come on, stay with me.
So let's jump into Adobe Premiere Pro and have a look at how to create this. Wedding season is nearly here, and that means if you're a wedding video editor, you're about to get super busy. Here's something to make your life a whole lot easier. A wedding video toolkit by Premium Beat. It's packed with elegant royalty-free music, After Effects templates, and some great free giveaways. You'll find the link in the description below. What's up, guys? Jordi here for cinecom.net, and welcome today to a very short Premiere tutorial, and that's because we are working on a bunch of stuff, but short doesn't mean that it's not cool. This is a pretty nice effect that Casey used in his latest mega vlog.
It's gonna be great. It's gonna be great.
Braincast number two!
This is Braincast number two.
So what you have to do is start with your first shot, and you can see that right here in our project panel, and you just kind of yap whatever you want to tell to your viewers. Just tell that to the camera. And after you've done that first shot, you can just import that into Premiere, put it into your timeline, like so, and then you are ready for the next shot. So then you have to take that SD card back out of your computer, put it in your camera again, and then we can start by playing this clip here inside our timeline and kind of filming it in that second shot. And as we're filming our screen, at a certain point, you just kind of pan away and do the next part of your speech. So important now is that we are going to sync these two first shots together. And we can kind of do this with looking for a specific word in our text. So let's look for that at the laptop part here.
Cool transition from a scene to his laptop.
So at a certain point, I'm saying laptop, for example.
From a scene to his laptop.
Laptop. So I'm going to try and sync it on there. And you can kind of nudge through this timeline here on top with your arrow keys to the left and to the right. And we're going to locate the part where I'm starting with saying laptop. And you can also see here my mount going open. And at this point, we want to set an endpoint. And we can do so by pressing the I key on our keyboard. And that will create this endpoint, as you can see right here. So now let's locate that exact same position here in the original clip.
Well, I did this pretty cool transition from a scene to his left.
And again, use your arrow keys to nudge. And this right here, as you can see, are the two exact same frames. So now we can kind of drag this clip here onto channel number two. And want to make sure that the sound as well is not overwriting here, like this. And now I'm sure that these two are synced up together. And now we can kind of play around with this. Pretty cool is that also your sound transitions from the real clip here to the laptop sound. So once they are synced, we can trim them again, make them bigger, make them smaller, it doesn't matter. Just make sure that you don't change them in position, because that will make them unsync from each other. Let's say at this point right here, it doesn't matter. We're going to trim the first clip so that the sound of the laptop here takes over. And if you want, you can now place them next to each other. That doesn't matter.
Well, I did this pretty cool transition from a scene to his laptop.
And maybe the sound is not going to be too well here, so you might want to adjust that too. We're going to take the pen tool here on the left side. You can also press the P key on your keyboard to bring up that pen tool. And we are going to create like these small keyframes here on this volume. For the volume, so let's create a keyframe here to start with on the right side, and we're going to set like this here is the volume at this point, but before that we kind of want the volume to be a little bit louder, so just drag that a little bit higher, like so, and now it will transition a bit better.
Yet, well, I did this pretty cool transition from a scene to his laptop.
Something like this. Pretty cool, huh? It's very simple to create. Alright, so this is the first cut that we're doing, in case you only did it once, but you can do this like in an endless loop. So let's also do the exact same thing with the third shot that we have right here. This is the exact same technique, guys. You want to look for a certain word that you can sync this with. So maybe at the word pretty cool that I'm saying here. So right here I'm starting with the word pretty cool. I want to look at my expression here, which is awesome. And I want to sync that up. And that is right here at this point. So you want to listen at both the audio to kind of match this and also the facial expression that you're making to sync that up. And if you want, so you can actually overwrite that with the previous clip. Because here's something pretty cool. You can also take the roll edit tool. You can find that in your toolbox right here on the side. So right here it is, the rolling edit tool. Or you can also press the N key on your keyboard. And what that allows you to do is kind of change where this edit is in your timeline to a different spot. And both of these clips will always stay in sync. So this is something pretty cool to do. So that way we can kind of choose at which point we have to transition to the laptop again. Maybe perhaps here. Let's have a listen.
Cool, huh? It's very simple to create. And come on, stay with me. So let's
All right, let's also make sure that the sound is a bit increased here as well.
Pretty cool, huh? It's very simple to create. And come on, stay with me. So let's jump into Adobe Premiere Pro and have a look at how to create this.
And that was it, guys. A pretty short, simple, but very effective tutorial. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe as well, as we're putting out multiple videos a week. But most importantly, always remember, stay creative.